U.S. Air Force style of warfare involves destroying enemy aircraft from a distance as the safest. To achieve this, fighter jets never fight without the support of THEDR aircraft and thorough reconnaissance. And when it comes to getting away from the pursuer and trying to attack him, what's much more practical is the IRB maneuver, a small J-shaped U-turn. The issue of the combat use of the Cobra has been discussed more than once, and there is no consensus. Some experts and pilots argue that such a sharp drop in speed can be useful in real combat, and there are positive examples. However, Peter Denakin, former head of the USSR and Russian Air Forces, said that this information was greatly exaggerated and, except for show, this focus did not match. US military experts are very wary of the idea of using aerobatics in real combat. The basic function of speed in aerial combat is that it is exchanged for a higher rotating speed and increased capacity to dodge incoming missiles. Fast deceleration can be used to surprise enemies during merging because you're not traveling along a trajectory where the enemy expects you to be, forcing pursuers to overshoot as just one example. In exchange for the loss of energy, it can deliver the opponent's plane on a silver plate. When there are jets trying to knock each other down, if one jet is behind you at all, you're done. The best you can do is to flap your wings from side to side, prancing, to avoid the bursts of fire. Otherwise, complex maneuvers are used with the aim of getting the enemy in front of you. Sorry, the whole Pugachev's Cobra maneuver, used to get behind enemy jets, is a cumbersome move, and the whole I can't lock up while flying in a big circle just undermines the fighter's actual capabilities. VTOL or vertical takeoff and landing jets often make like Avengers Quinjets and hover, land smoothly, and even fire from a fixed flight position. Any seasoned fighter pilot would laugh if they saw the F-35B take off and spin straight for flight, as some seem to do. The reality is, most lifts and landings are automated, and turning around before you're ready to fly is a ridiculous idea. Hovering or even shooting, it's crazy. That said, taking off and landing in real-life VTOL is an impressive and even unnatural-looking sight. The Eurofighter Typhoon provides an enviable level of flexibility and efficiency. A true swing roll capability, this wide field of view offers significant benefits in both air-to-air and air-to-surface interactions, and given the large force and available aperture, provides pilots with significantly better angle coverage compared to fixed plate systems. The state-of-the-art cockpit design and layout is based on an extensive series of formal assessments in a rapid prototype facility, carried out by operational pilots of the Air Force flying the Eurofighter Typhoon. Using and upgrading advanced digital technology not only improves operability and survivability, but also simplifies aircraft maintenance. Super maneuverability may be irrelevant to modern air combat depending on the doctrine. Western military powers believe today because they have many times in the past that aerial combat is obsolete. Technologies such as low-observable airframe radars, data fusion, and advances in missiles appear to be an attempt to kill aerial combat, while stealth-optimized radars, additional UHF, L-band antennas, and long-range DRFM interference keep air combat relevant. The high agility demonstrated by the Sukhoi Su-35S fighter at the Paris Air Show is rooted in the Russian concept where close air combat and low speed remain important, according to Sukhoi chief test pilot Sergey Bogdan. It is fair to note that the tricks performed by the F-18 on record are not quite as Cobra as the Russian Su-27 fighter jets show. The fact is that schools of aerobatics differ greatly between countries. To understand this difference, let's turn to the history of the Pugachev Cobra. But the Cobra maneuvers in fact endanger the pilot and the plane itself, because air-to-air missiles like the AIM-9 Sidewinder are easy to shoot at the Su-35, because the missile can handle all Su-35 maneuvers up to the 10G point. Taught and then issued a chaff countermeasure so that the missiles were lured away from the plane and instead of doing the Cobra maneuver.